Why is the sun hot? Think about it. Our sun is basically a giant nuclear reactor at the center of our solar system. But it's not like the ones here on Earth. They create energy by nuclear fission. That is, they split large atoms like uranium into smaller, lighter ones, and in the process release a large amount of energy. Atomic bombs also work in the same way, which is the reason why they are so destructive. The sun creates its energy by nuclear fusion, the most efficient way to create energy in the universe other than matter-antimatter annihilation. Fusion works the other way around and fuses the nuclei or the centre of atoms of the lightest and most abundant element in the universe, hydrogen, together under enormous pressure and heat to create helium, the second most abundant and lightest element in the universe. Again, in the process of doing this, a huge amount of energy is released, and this ultimately provides the energy for all life on Earth. Compared to the Earth, the Sun is massive. You could fit 1 million Earths into the Sun and still have a bit of room left over for more. It measures 864,000 miles across. The Earth, by comparison, is a piffling 7,918 miles across. At the centre of the Sun is the core. This is the heart of the Sun and where 99% of the nuclear fusion takes place. And even this is about 200,000 miles across, 16,000 times the size of the Earth. As the mass of the Sun's core is so great, the effect of gravity is so strong that the pressure inside the core is about 265 billion times greater than that of air pressure at sea level on Earth. This enormous pressure pushes up the temperature to 15 million degrees Celsius, and that combination of pressure and heat allows the fusion to occur and the energy to be released. Every second, the core of a sun converts 600 million tons of hydrogen to helium. Of this, the equivalent of about 4 million tons of hydrogen is converted into energy. To give you an idea of just how huge that amount of energy is, according to Enerdata.net, the world's entire consumption of energy in 2015, including oil, gas, coal, and electricity, was about 13,400 megatonne. Now, if you're unfamiliar with a tonne measurement, it means tonne of oil equivalent, or the amount of energy released by burning 1 tonne of oil. Not 1 barrel of oil, 1 tonne of oil. So the total energy used by us humans in 2015 was the equivalent to burning 13,400 million tonnes of oil. But when we compare that to the output of the sun will put out enough energy in 1 second to power the entire world for just over 688,000 years. The astronomer George Abel illustrated it in another way. Imagine a bridge of ice 2 miles wide by 1 mile thick, extending the 93 million miles from the Earth to the Sun. If all the Sun's energy were focused onto it, it would melt the whole thing in just 1 second. Luckily for us, this energy is radiated out in all directions, so we only receive a tiny fraction of it, otherwise the Earth would be burned to a crisp. In fact, the Earth receives just 0.0000045% of the Sun's total output. But even this is still 7,500 times more than we consume. Now, while the centre of the Sun is 15 million degrees, by the time the energy reaches the surface, it's down to a much more manageable 5,500 degrees Kelvin, which, if you're into photography, film or video, is where you get the colour temperature of daylight from. From here, it takes just 8 minutes for the light to reach Earth. When it arrives, some of it is reflected back into space and some is absorbed by the atmosphere. But on a clear day, around 70% of it reaches the surface to then warm the atmosphere and give us our Goldilocks zone planet, which is not too hot and it's not too cold. It's just the right temperature. The Sun is a middle-aged star, and although it's been going for around about 4.5 billion years, it's been getting brighter as it gets older at the rate of around 1% every 100 million years. In another 1 billion years, it will be 10% brighter than it is now. And although that might not seem like much, it will probably make the Earth too hot to support complex life like us. So we have a few 100 million years left to evolve into a spacefaring species and find a new home amongst the outer planets or out in the stars beyond. That's if we don't make ourselves extinct in the process And if we do, we've just got to hope that whatever life evolves after us can do a better job before the sun cooks the earth. So as always, thanks for watching, and please subscribe, rate, and share.